How many of you are guilty of knowing exactly how much miles you have left until you actually have to fill up your car when the little gas light turns on? I know, I'm guilty just as much as anyone else is. Well, did you know that that's the number one reason why fuel pumps go out?
I know, we're gonna have to stop.
I'm Sally Tanmola. My husband Derek and I run Auto Rehab. We've owned our own shop for 7 years, and Derek's been in the automotive industry for 15 plus years. So I already shared with you one tip that we're gonna talk about in today's video regarding fuel pumps. There's two reasons why fuel pumps go out, and you'll learn the second one in this video. Also, we're giving you a diagnosing tip of how to realize if it is a fuel pump, and we're even giving you a little secret at the end of this video to let you know what to look out for when you go into a shop to make sure they're not overselling something else. So, Derek, take it away.
Fuel-injected engines, we have in all of our vehicles. Used a pump that's in the tank. So I'm gonna show you kind of, this is kind of a very basic fuel pump that is inside your gas tank. Now this piece here, in reality, is the pump that is internal inside here. This unit here is an entire fuel pump assembly. This is typically what we replace in your vehicle. We do not typically replace this little pump, unless you have some of the import vehicles use just this, we have to install it into the module. But for the most part, these fuel pump modules are what get replaced. So kind of a pricey unit. It does have pressure sensors here for the evaporative emissions. It has fuel supply, fuel return on vehicles that have that kind of a system. But it also does a fuel level sender. So this will check how much fuel is in your tank. So it is quite a few components. Even if just the pump fails, they typically replace the entire unit. All the electronics go through the same housing. It is something you could replace just the pump, but oftentimes afterwards you'll have a problem with the level sender, or you'll have a problem with the evaporative pressure sensor, something along those lines. So we replace the entire unit. Now, the fuel pump, its purpose is to pick fuel up out of the tank, supply it to the engine. On a lot of newer vehicles, they will have a returnless system, meaning there's only one fuel pressure line that goes to the rail. The module itself will determine how much fuel pressure to send up to the rail. On most vehicles before this returnless system, we had a fuel supply on the engine. There's a fuel pressure regulator, and it'll return the additional fuel back to the tank that's not needed. So two different systems, still the same kind of a pump. However, these fuel pumps, in order to replace them, we are removing the tank off your vehicle for the most part, and then pulling the module out of it to replace it. And so labor can be a little bit much, but the module itself is typically the more expensive part of the whole ordeal. We do recommend typically a higher quality one. So there is cheaper ones that you can buy, and they'll look the same. You can hold two next to each other and they look identical. The difference is how long they last. So cheaper components internally, cheaper pump, cheaper regulator, cheaper electronics. And so it is worth getting a good quality pump when you're doing this kind of a job, if you have to. Understand. So a lot of us are used to driving till the fuel light comes on, and then we go get fuel. And that's just what we're used to.
You're guilty of that.
Everyone's done it. When your tank gets to about half or a third, fueling up at that point has many benefits. One of the biggest benefits is, if this is your fuel pump, in your tank, when the level gets down to about here, so your bottom third or half, it'll begin, as it goes below that, it'll begin to expose the physical fuel pump. The fuel pump, the reason the manufacturer put it in the tank is to cool it. So to keep this motor cool, this motor's running all the time, and to keep it cool, it just sits in the fuel, and that's how it stays cool. The pump itself, when it gets hot, meaning when the fuel level goes below the pump, the bushings inside will expand and wear out, and it'll run fine while it's hot. The problem is, when it cools off, that metal that's worn away shrinks back. So when you go to fire it up, and it has to spin twice as hard to create that pressure, that's where you've worn the pump out. And so keeping your tank half full, or at least a third and higher, helps your pump to live longer, that it doesn't wear itself out. And that's one of the biggest advantages to prevent you from having to have a fuel pump done. Secondly, when you fill up gas at a gas station, so there's big tanks underneath the gas station, they fill them full of fuel, there's naturally some sediment that gets in there. And when you end up pumping some of that into your tank every now and then, that's just normal. And that's why the pumps typically will have a pickup screen to filter it, and then most vehicles in line, there's an inline fuel filter to catch that kind of a sediment. Some of these newer vehicles don't have a fuel filter. A lot of the return the systems, it's just one line, and they just expect when that pump goes out, you just replace it. The fuel pump, when your tank gets lower, any sediment that's in the bottom of that tank is more likely to get sucked up by your fuel pump. That's a second danger that wears out the pump. So we have two things that wear the pump out. One, when your fuel gets low, sediment can get sucked up. And two, as it's low, the pump's exposed, wears itself out. So those two things can be prevented simply by fueling up more often or earlier before you get down to the light coming on. As the pump gets older, some of the telltale signs that you'll begin to notice, some people do. Sometimes the fuel pump will just fail. It'll just flat out just not turn on. You'll go to crank the car and it just cranks, and the engine doesn't start. Like some people describe it like it's not catching or not firing. That's usually a dead fuel pump most often. If fuel pump starts to wear out, people will notice that they go out to start their car in the morning and it cranks just longer than it usually has. It'll crank, and then start instead of just cranking and starting. And so as a pump wears out, that longer extended crank is trying to build fuel pressure with a worn out fuel pump so that the engine can start. So if your car starts exhibiting those kind of problems, that's an opportunity to get it into the shop, have a fuel pressure test done to confirm whether it needs a fuel pump or not, to prevent you from being stranded on the side of the road and coming on a tow truck. If you're in a crisis, and this is not something that we actively tell you to do, if you're in a crisis and the vehicle is stuck somewhere and it won't start, sometimes people have been able to have somebody either kick the gas tank or tap the gas tank with something while somebody else cranks, and sometimes it'll fire up. And all that's doing is inside the pump, there's an aperture, and it's so worn out that it can't make electrical contact. So by tapping it, it creates vibration and it'll jump the contact and fire up. If it does start that way, which you can do that if you need, we don't necessarily recommend it, but if you needed to in an emergency situation, you can get a vehicle here to the shop that way. Once it starts, it's highly recommended to get it to the shop immediately because it might not start again. We don't want vehicles to be dying in intersections and having an issue. And if you're somewhere away from people, that's a last resort.
Now we tell you that tip is a last minute effort to get it to a shop immediately, okay? Don't go run errands, don't go pick up your child from school, just get it to a shop immediately because we can't guarantee that once it starts again that you will actually be good to go for even 10 more minutes. So make sure that you get it to a shop as soon as that happens.
Oftentimes they will upsell a fuel injection cleaning and a top end cleaning and a lot of these things, and those are beneficial. They're absolutely beneficial to most vehicles, but they're not exactly mandatory. So oftentimes some shop will focus on the fact that they've had an issue that won't let the car start. So if we can add this on right now, they would do it. And unfortunately, that happens. With the new pump, it will have increased rail pressure. It will actually clean your injectors out to some degree just based off of the additional pressure. So top end cleaning is beneficial for carbon removal, but fuel injection cleaning, not mandatory when you have a fuel pump fail. My personal recommendation, get the pump in, run it, see how well it drives, see if it idles great, try it out for a week at least, let it clean itself out. If you still have drivability issues afterwards, then get the injection cleaning if it needs it.
Thanks, Derek, for all that information. If you like that video, go ahead and push like, and then comment below. Let us know if you're guilty, yes, of allowing your fuel to go down a little bit too low. Also, share this video with all of your friends. We'd love to get this information out to as many people as possible. And lastly, subscribe to our channel so you get these amazing videos every single Wednesday. Thanks for watching.